Buongiorno. The area of interest is in central South Sicily. It's characterized by the most complete sequences of Messinian evaporite outcrops, locally known as Gessoso Solfifera Formation, marked by rock salt, sulfur, bitumen, and metal ores. The Platani River Valley, placed west of Agrigento, shows peculiar geomorphological features: salt, sulfur, bitumen, whose use has been documented since prehistory. In these pictures, you can see the Platani River with salt incrustation and salt that accumulated around the water spring. In the Platani Valley, the salt is everywhere, accumulated in huge, very huge heaps. In these pictures, the salt accumulated on the edges of a stream, tributary of the Platani River. In this picture, the heap of salt, but is very usually in the valley of the Platani. Long-lasting settlements are attested, but we can't find archaeological evidences because the salt was collected very easily on the surface without resorting to mine extraction. We have many historical sources that quote the salt of Agrigento, for example, Plinius the Elder, Solinus Agostino, especially for the very large quantities, for the purity that made it immediately edible. We can't find archaeological remains such as boiling salt pots or tools for mining because there was no need, because the salt was collected on the surface very easily. Until the last century, the local inhabitants collected the salt for normal uses. The concentration of long-lasting settlements is attested also near the sulfur mines from Eraclea Minoa, where the Platani flows into the Mediterranean Sea, to inland, where are very important sites, such as Monte Sara, Sant'Angelo Muxaro, Monte Roveto a Castel Termini, Monte Raffe a Milena. The area surrounding Agrigento was one of the richest areas in sulfur. It was very important in several fields, cultural and medical use. We find archaeological evidences about extraction and processing of sulfur in the site of Monte Grande at Palma di Montechiaro, where is melted sulfur from early Bronze Age layer associated with local painted and Aegean sheds. A fragment of melted sulfur come from Monte Roveto a Castel Termini. In the Platani Valley there are also a lot of sources of bitumen. The most important are in the Bonura district in the Valle dell'Olio. and at Bivona, where the Madonna dell'Olio is venerated. In these pictures, bitumen on a surface. We have a lot of literary resources on the bitumen of Agrigento territory, and describe the importance of the oil of Agrigento and the properties and the uses of the bitumen. These are the local raw materials that can possibly explain the Aegean presences along the Agrigento coast from Palma di Montechiaro, Monte Grande, to Cannatello until the Platani River and the Platani Valley with the site or the important site such as Aragona and Cannatello. You can see the Mycenaean and the Cypriot vessel from Aragona Caldare and two sheet bronze balls and three sword of Pertosa, Thapsos Pertosa type. From two sheet bronze balls from Sant'Angelo Muxaro and from Milena Monte Campanella. One of the important Aegean influence are in the architecture, funerary architecture. You can see some examples of Tholos tombs from Sant'Angelo Muxaro with a vast rock cut Tholos tomb from Anguilla, necropoli Anguilla di Ribera and Castel Termini. Worthy of note are the metal resources, especially iron ore such as pyrite, hematite, magnetite. They seem to be concentrated in the middle Platani Valley between Sant'Angelo Muxaro and Monte Roveto at Castel Termini, that a new geological map has evidenced. Monte Roveto is the most important site in the middle Platani Valley, where there are evidences of metal working with finished objects, slugs and ingots. You can see AS rude and iron bloom on the surface that we can find everywhere in a very vast area. Bronze ingots, ice rude and smelting slugs. Element very important is aspect very important is the presence of sources of metal ore. The huge amount of iron bloom suggests the presence of iron working. In this picture, iron spongy bloom with voids and bubbles. In this picture, throat iron bloom. In a bronze and iron hoard, there are bronze and iron items. In bronze, two spears that date from that date to 10th century, a lot of beads, fragment of great, two punches melted in one piece, two little horses, and 3 kilos of bronze ingots and ice rude. In iron, 2 knives, 2 hoes, and 1 axe. The presence in the hoard of iron ore, iron bloom, suggests that they have been stored intentionally. Recent archaeological investigation on Monte Roveto have certainly shed new light about iron technology in Sicily, primarily for the local metal sources. The huge presence of iron gave the name for the to the site that locally is called Monteferro. The planned archaeometric analysis can help to understand many aspects about the local metal working and about the problem of the beginnings of iron smelting. Not only sulfur, salt and bitumen in the Valley of the Platani, but also, as is evidenced at Monte Roveto in the middle Platani Valley, also the processing of iron, of local iron. Thank you.